Last week, a community center for LGBTQ and people in the West African country closed its doors after mounting pressure by religious groups and anti-gay organizations against sexual minorities. Police later raided the center, its staff said, after its leaders were forced into hiding. In recent weeks, several high-profile figures in Ghana had demanded the closure of the center, intended to be a safe space for LGBTQ and people to meet and find support. Yet since the center's opening in January in the capital, Accra, many people have received death threats and online abuse. The opening of the center amplified discrimination against the community, said activists. Although same-sex relationships are illegal in Ghana, the law is rarely enforced, according to a 2018 report by Human Rights Watch. Yet activists say abuse against LGBTQ and Ghanaians has intensified in recent years, fueled by influential anti-gay campaigners. Will Ghana allow gays and lesbians to live freely in Ghana? According to Amnesty International, in too many countries, being lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender or intersex means living with daily discrimination. This discrimination could be based on your sexual orientation, who you're attracted to. From name-calling and bullying to being denied a job or appropriate health care, the range of unequal treatment faced is extensive and damaging. It can also be life-threatening. In recent times, there have been surges in the persecution of gay and lesbians in Ghana, especially gays. The President of Ghana, His Excellency Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, reported that he will not legalize gay and lesbianism. This is what he said.
I have said this before, and let me in conclusion stress again that it will not be under the presidency of Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo that same-sex marriage will be legal.
Individuals outside of Ghana signing letters backing gay rights in Ghana. Idris Elba and Naomi Campbell sign letter backing gay rights in Ghana. Idris Elba OBE is an English actor, writer, producer, rapper, singer, songwriter, and DJ. Whilst Naomi Campbell is an English model, actress, and businesswoman. Some of the UK's most prominent people of Ghanaian heritage have joined together to condemn their former homeland for its stance on gay rights in what will be seen as an extraordinary show of diaspora power. The influential names in fashion, film, and media, including Idris Elba and the Vogue editor-in-chief, Edward Enenfool, have signed an open letter in support of Ghana's LGBTQ and community. Naomi Campbell, although not of Ghanaian heritage, has also put her name to the letter. The letter, signed by 67 celebrities, politicians, and other influential people largely of Ghanaian heritage, said they were deeply disturbed by the events and called on Ghana's president, Nana Akufo-Addo, and other political leaders to offer protection to the LGBTQ and community. We have watched with profound concern as you have had to question the safety of your vital work at the LGBT and Rights Ghana Center in Accra and feared for your personal well-being and security. It is unacceptable to us that you feel unsafe, it said. As prominent and powerful advocates for this great country, we are beseeching His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Ghana, Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, and political or cultural leaders to create a pathway for allyship, protection, and support. We petition for inclusivity which will make the nation even greater and even stronger, it continued.